Just another kind of to reiterate what happened last time. Full auto Luger. Works great. Hopefully I can do this. Slide a little thing down. Pull the plate off, which this one's hard to get off. The one on my original Luger was quite easy. Come on. Come on. Fiddle with it. Fiddle with it. There we go. Slide lock. That's why I did it. Anyway. Come on. Focus on it. There we go. As you can see, it's pretty much smooth all the way across. I can grab it. Piece of metal. Just some Coke can metal. That's perfect resilience, rigidity, whatever you want to call it. You know, just kind of reamed it out to where it was a straight shot across it. That way the arm could push up. Yeah, get it back down here. And the arm, whenever it pushed up, instead of pushing up on the button, it would push on the shim, which then would apply pressure all the way across the bar, which would hold it at this angle. And whenever the bolt cycled up, pulled the upper assembly back, whenever it pushed forward again, it pushed into that angle, which then pushed the trigger or hammer release again. It's a pretty easy system to take advantage of if you're trying to do this. Sorry about that. So yeah, your standard run-of-the-mill trigger assembly plate thing, and then your modified one. It'll have the front of it intact, and then the ridged two-level system. Come on, there we go. And then over here, it's ground down to where it's flat and kind of smooth all the way across. And yeah, it's simple, and it does. I can't see any difference because it still works perfectly fine in semi-auto if I just take this piece of metal out. So I don't see any problem with doing it and then saying, oh, I don't like this, I don't like full auto, I want to go back to semi. It works perfectly fine. So yeah, I guess a reiteration video.